already been one trying weekend. Persistent rain, a string of serious accidents, an hour upon hour of waiting put teams on the edge. Randy Pemberton takes a look back at our race day rewind.
The racetrack was a total washout Thursday. Friday wasn't much better as rain kept practice to a minimum for both divisions. Then Winston Cup practice prior to qualifying was cut short when rookie Steve Park made heavy contact with the outside wall several times before finally bouncing off pit wall and coming to rest. Park was diagnosed with several injuries, including a broken collarbone, scapula, and right leg. He had surgery on his leg at Georgia Baptist Medical Center and is expected to miss most of the remaining schedule in 1998. Qualifying for the Primestar 500 did take place Friday afternoon with John Andretti winning the pole position. Other notable stories included Todd Bodine making his first race of the season and Sterling Marlin missing one for the first time since 1986. But that would be the end of any race cars on the track for two solid days as Mother Nature unleashed several inches of rain in Atlanta. The Busch race was washed out altogether, and the Cup race, which nearly rolled off on Sunday, didn't get the green flag until almost noon Monday, leaving the teams without any practice time and the racetrack without any rubber on it. A bad combination, raising the question of how far the cars could run before wearing out the right side tires or worse. After a couple of early yellow flags, including one from Mike Skinner, who suffered a concussion from this wreck, the crews got a chance to check the tires, and it wasn't good. They made it to lap 206 before Derek Cope crashed hard in turn two. He spent the night in the hospital with two broken ribs. The whole day was a test of nerve and patience. As expected, four drivers paced the pack much of the afternoon, with rookie Kenny Irwin and teammate Dale Jarrett showing the way for nearly half of the 325 laps.
Until you actually do it and run up front with these guys, you don't know, you know, if you can do it. And so, and I had a lot to prove to myself today, not only to Robert, but to everybody else too.
Chevy fans had little to smile about for the third straight week as Jeff Gordon was unable to mount much of a run to the front. Likewise for Dale Earnhardt or anybody else in a Monte Carlo, with the exception of Terry Labonte, who made a charge with about 100 laps to go, but that wouldn't last as he would end up 12th, the highest finishing Chevy chauffeur.
We've got some issues to address, you know, within our own race team. You know, we haven't been the strongest Chevy the last 2 weeks in a row, and that's something I want to get sorted out. I'm going to let everybody else fight this political battle.
The GM camp did have two Pontiacs in the top 10, with Todd Bodine having a solid finish in 10th and Bobby Labonte locking up the victory after stealing the lead from Dale Jarrett in lap traffic on lap 279 and never looking back.
Did some adjustments on the car that were right and got up behind Dale Jarrett and really got going fast. This thing was, got up to speed real good that time and felt good and caught him in some traffic, got by him, and for our tires equaled out a little bit and I stayed the same. But it was a good run for us.
Now, after the race, NASCAR impounded two Chevys, two Fords, and Labonte's Pontiac. They'll go to the wind tunnel in nearby Marietta, Georgia, checking those aerodynamic numbers on all three body styles, and it could issue some more rule changes in the very near future. Well, an update now on a few drivers injured last week in Atlanta. As Randy told you, Steve Park had the most serious injuries, including a broken femur, shoulder blade, and collarbone. He was transferred back to Charlotte this week and is now recovering at home. Get well, Steve. He's expected to miss most of the rest of the season. An update on the number one team's plans later in race day. Also in Atlanta, Mike Skinner was shaken up pretty good in an early race incident. Ironically, he hit the wall in nearly the same spot that Park did. Skinner doesn't remember much from his wreck, which has left him sore with pain in his right shoulder, neck, and left leg from strained muscles. But x-rays and a CAT scan were both negative, and Skinner hopes to be ready for action next weekend at Darlington. Derek Cope expects to be back in the number 30 Gumout Pontiac at Darlington. He had a good run going before smacking the concrete late in the event. His cracked ribs are healing quickly, and the team spokesman says Cope is feeling less and less pain every day. Cope will not drive in the Busch Series event today in Nashville, turning over his number 92 car to David Green. Well, the Winston Cup and Busch Series events last weekend weren't the only ones affected by the weather. In our Mopar performance update, Mother Nature also watched out the NHRA's Gator Nationals in Gainesville, Florida last Sunday. That event was also made up this week, and you saw the finals right here yesterday on TNN. Bob Fry had the call, and he has our recap.
Mike, we had spectacular finals at the Rain-Delay Mac Tools Gator Nationals. We gave away $85,000 in bonus money from the folks at MBNA. Went out in virtually every pro category except Top Fuel. Let's take a look at those championship runs. And in pro stock, it was a battle of the two titans of that class, Warren Johnson and Jim Yates. And I don't think anybody out there figures that the Winston Championship this year won't be won by one of these two guys. Warren Johnson, who's been doing a wonderful job of driving all day long, gets a great start out of the gate. He has been over 200 miles an hour each run coming into the finals. He would go over 200 miles an hour again and beat Jim Yates by a car length. The funny car category saw John Forrest looking to win for the first time in 98 against Cruz Pedregon, who hasn't won since 96. The two of them, classic final rounds they've given us in the past. This would be no exception. They both smoked the tires. Ironically enough, Cruz Pedregon outpedals the seven-time Winston champ. Cruz Pedregon wins for Joe Gibbs in the Interstate Batteries car.
It was a wild ride. It didn't look like much, but if we'd had an onboard camera, you'd have seen some serious driving. But Hot Rod was a hot rodder today, and I'm just happy for Pontiac and all the people to stick with us.
And Top Fuel, it was the battle of the bears. It's the red car. Kenny Bernstein against the Miller Lite car of Larry Dixon. Kenny Bernstein, who loves this racetrack, would win his first ever in Top Fuel, but in spectacular fashion. Larry Dixon would come up a bit short. He exploded the motor and then brings the car safely to a halt at the end of the racetrack. But Kenny Bernstein is your Gator Nationals champion.
Have I got it straight? Lee Beard is now the winningest crew chief in Top Fuel.
He was tied at